vampire and Lycan clans have been at war for centuries, turning our world into a battlefield.
Are you with me?
I was curious, what is it that keeps you coming back?
I think every time it's kind of a case-by-case thing. I think, you know, obviously I've never played another part more than once before, and it's lovely that there is so much fan love for her, and I think every time it comes up as a question, it's kind of, okay, well, what can we give them that's a different facet? What's different? You know, and this time, you know, she's incredibly disillusioned at the start of the movie, but it is probably the most sort of raw, emotionally exposed that she's ever been, and I really like that for her.
Yeah, and it's cool too, because I love the fact that this is a franchise that is so wildly successful, but it doesn't originate from a comic book in this, you know, Marvel crazy world.
Exactly, and I think that's one of the things that I feel, you know, obviously the fact of being a female-led franchise and it getting to a fifth installment, number one, is really, you know, unusual, and it's almost completely unusual that it's an original idea. And I think the big shame is, I think it's clear that fans love an original thing, and it doesn't always have to be based on something. And that's proved because they keep coming to see these, you know, these movies, and it's nice because it's a surprise for everybody each time. It's not like, oh, I read the book, I know what's coming. You know, it's kind of a nice thing. So I don't know, hopefully it'll encourage a little bit more original ideas, because I think that so many filmmakers have such great original ideas and they don't get them made.
Yeah, and it's not necessarily the first female-led franchise, but it's definitely one of the earliest.
Yeah, I mean, obviously we all kneel before Sigourney Weaver and Linda Hamilton, who were there way before us, but at the time of the first Underworld, it was definitely an issue of like, ooh, this is a risk. It's, you know, is it going to work with a female? And it's so difficult to make it work. And I don't think that's quite the same conversation now. So being part of having moved that conversation around a little bit feels pretty great.
The Lycans have resolved to exterminate us.
They have a new leader, Marius. He wants the blood of Selene.
If they use it, the Lycan's power will be limitless.
And now, not only is it a female-led franchise that's got a lot of strong female roles in it, but it's being led by a woman, Anna Forrester, as the director.
Yeah, exactly. We have a female director. We have, you know, that's the other thing that I really like about this particular movie, is that we've got some really, you know, some supporting characters who are, you know, really dynamic females also. And, you know, we're kind of gently waving the flag for the chicks over here, which I like.
How do you think Blood Wars benefits from having a woman take on Selene?
I think the thing is, you know, for this particular movie, we definitely wanted to make her, you know, have a kind of really emotional ride. And not to say that men can't do that, not to say that that's what women are good at. I've never met Anna as in a male form, so I don't know how many of her qualities are female and how many of just herself, but she was a really big fan of the movie, which I really liked. She was very invested in all of the characters, you know, development and stuff, and she was incredibly collaborative. So we got to really hash a lot of stuff out, which was great.
That's so exciting. Like, why do you think it's so difficult for women to be handpicked blockbusters, and how do you think Anna handled it?
And she handled it really well. You would never have known it was her first movie, number one. Obviously, she's incredibly experienced in the movie industry, and she's done, you know, she's done a lot of shooting, as it wasn't like her first gig at all. But she, you know, she was absolutely perfect for this. I don't know, I think there's a lot of things that are changing about, you know, how people think of women traditionally, and I guess there's a little opposition of that to that coming up, and we all have to be galvanizing ourselves.
You must go north. You will find answers there.
War has followed you here.
So there was a lot of medieval weaponry and old school weapons in this. Did you do a lot of intensive training to prepare for this role?
Not as much as I did on the first movie, where I was just a complete novice and didn't know how to run or punch or anything, and had to be kind of like completely from scratch, Karate Kid situation. But yeah, I'm very comfortable with guns. Weirdly, it was the only thing that I was naturally immediately good at on the first movie. And of course, they took most of them away on this, which sucks. Every time they give me a new weapon, I completely panic and say, I definitely won't be able to do it. Or, don't give me a sword or an axe, but, you know. And we've got an amazing stunt team who are very patient and know that I have to go through that slight panic stage first. So it's a lot of practicing in parking lots and alleyways and all that.
So what's up next for Selene and the future of the Underworld franchise?
Yeah, I mean, that's the one thing. I've always said that's the last one. I mean, I, after the first one, I thought it was the last one, so I'm the least reliable source to ask for that. But I guess we'll see. I don't know. Let's see if the fans like this one.